Hello, I'm Oriana. Welcome to another exciting Tech Talk video, brought to you by Zyxel Networks. Today, we are going to introduce a pro feature that allows you to quickly understand the quality of your Wi-Fi network and set self-repairing policies. And the function is called Wireless Health. In a deployment project, verification and performance test are executed when we finish placing the AP, and everything is usually fine at the moment. However, the wireless environment is constantly changing. It is often difficult to maintain the quality of the network stable for a long time because as interference increases, or changes in site layout and user behavior, users often accumulate dissatisfaction over a long period before expressing it. Only then do network administrators become aware of the problem and spend a lot of time investigating and adjusting network settings. To investigate the issue, network administrators have to check countless event logs. They may need to use keywords AP and client MAC address to further clarify the problem. What's even more challenging is that they still need to evaluate each disconnection scenario individually. For example, did the client roam to another AP while moving around the office? Or did the user connect his laptop to a wired network, leading the device to stop using Wi-Fi and getting disconnected? All these inconveniences not only cause difficulties for network administrators in troubleshooting, but also delay the resolution of the problem. To address these aforementioned inconveniences for network administrators, Zyxel presents Wireless Health, a groundbreaking solution for providing better Wi-Fi network clarity for network administrators in troubleshooting and deliver the resolution of the problem. In the overview section, administrators can clearly see how many devices in the current environment are operating well and which ones are experiencing poor transmission. These statuses are updated every 3 minutes, accumulated over time, and forms a clear overview graph of Wi-Fi network. In this graph, the x-axis represents different times period in the past, while the dots on y-axis means the transmission quality of each device, which also categorized by different colors. Devices with poorer transmission will be placed higher up and represented in red. Ideally, all the dots in the graph are green, indicating that all Wi-Fi transmissions are smooth and without anomalies. Conversely, when the dots are all red, means that Wi-Fi transmissions are interfered, and we need to optimize the setting to deal with the interference. Although the actual situation often won't be that clear and distinct as we just mentioned. However, this graph can help us to analyze how network quality changes over time. Take the Wi-Fi network of an SMB as an example, where we can see how the occurrences of transmission anomalies through past time periods. The transmission issue occurring during peak office hours are due to the higher number of people moving around the company, causing more frequent changes in the wireless environment. Therefore, we don't need to be overly concerned about the anomalies during this time period. However, why there are still anomalies during non-working hours? By ruling out factors like client behavior and configuration changes, we can infer that these anomalies originate from nearby interference, and administrator needs to optimize the Wi-Fi settings to deal with it. Wireless Health also offers compact optimization choices, eliminating the need for users to go through complex troubleshooting steps. We will discuss the details of this later in the content. On top of the graph, Wireless Health also compiles a list of the top 10 devices with poor transmission. Users can also quickly identify if the transmission issue only happens on specific device, or lots of devices are suffering poor transmission together. We have just introduced how to determine the problematic time period based on the overview and the density of red dots in the graph. Next, we will introduce technically how these alerts are being calculated. How AP identify transmission anomalies is based on the ratio of retransmissions. In Wi-Fi transmission, the transmitter must receive a confirmation from the receiver to consider the data successfully transmitted. And, if there is no response received within a certain time, the transmitter will resend the data. When an AP retransmit too many times within the period, it is recorded as an alert. APs with too many alerts are identified as having poor performance. Through this way, normal disconnection behavior is not miscounted, since AP won't send data to a disconnect client, ensuring the accuracy of wireless health. To improve poor transmission, we need to minimize the occurrence of retransmissions. For both APs and clients, retransmissions originate from two main reasons: environmental interference and poor signal strength. The former occurs when different APs use overlapping channels, causing their transmissions to interfere with each other and leading to retransmissions. The solution in this case is to segregate the channels used to ensure smooth transmission among them. Zyxel APs use DCS periodically to segregate the using channels. However, in places where APs are owned by different administrators, any network changes may interfere other APs, and network administrators may take lots of efforts to solve the performance issue in time. The latter issue, poor signal strength, occurs in poorly chosen deployment locations. AP may be placed in a corner, with too many obstacles towards the client. Or, the client remains connected to a distant AP instead of switching to a closer one. The good news is that wireless health allows APs to automatically optimize its settings to deal with poor transmission. When you find an increase in poor transmissions at unexpected period, or receiving more complaints from Wi-Fi users, without complex settings, simply enable the feature, and the AP will make corresponding adjustments when it detects an alert. The radio optimization addresses environmental interference issues. In adaptive channel width, APs reduce their bandwidth usage to 20 MHz to minimize overlap. DCS, on the other hand, allows APs to switch directly to less interfered channels, ensuring good quality for subsequent transmissions. Client optimization is used to deal with sticky clients. Instead of setting disconnection thresholds, APs will proactively kick off clients with more retransmissions. Thus, when a client is disconnected by a distant AP, it will attempt to reconnect and connect to a closer one, and get better signal. The aggressiveness setting determines under which traffic loading can AP initiate the optimization. If users are seeking for fast response to interference, and can tolerate the potential risk of short disconnection, they can set it to high. This way, even if the AP has live traffic, it will still switch channels for instant performance improvement. On the other hand, if users seek stable and continuous connection, even if it means lower performance due to interference, and wish for any optimization to occur only after transmission has ended, they can opt for the low setting. Well, that's it for today's Tech Talk. I believe this video provides you full understanding to this powerful feature, and use it in daily network management. Like, comment, and subscribe. And I hope to see you in our next video. Have a nice day.
We're Zyxel, and we're your networking ally.